White.
What?
The pupils were white like that.
Were you so white in the center?
Yes, like that.
Mm-hmm. Was he near the silver object, or was he far from
it? No, on top.
On top of the silver object. Okay. And did you look at him?
Yes.
Did he look at you?
Yes, then he gave me the creeps, then I stopped looking.
Gave you the creeps. Actually, in your drawing, you showed him standing up, didn't you?
Yes, I had to draw him standing up because I couldn't draw him sitting. What I thought was maybe the war's going to end. Maybe they're telling us the war's going to end.
Why do you think they might want us to be scared?
Because we don't look after the planet and the area properly.
Mm-hmm. And is this an idea that you have had before, that we don't look after the planet properly in the air, or did this idea come to you when you had this experience?
When I had this experience.
Mm-hmm. And how did that idea come to you from this experience? This is a little hard, but try to be with me here, okay? How did this idea come to you when you had this experience?
I just felt all horrible inside.
You felt horrible? At what point did you feel that? When you saw the craft, or when you got home at night? Or
when I got home.
You had that horrible feeling when you got home?
Yes.
And say more about that horrible feeling, Lisa. What was it like?
It was like in the world, all the trees will just go down and there will be no air and people will be dying.
Mm-hmm. And those thoughts came to you. Had you had those thoughts before this experience?
No.
And how did those thoughts come to you? Did they come to you from the craft or from?
From the man.
The man. And the man, did the man say those things to you? How did he get that across to you?
Well, he never said anything. It's just that the face is the eyes.
What was the sense you got from those eyes?
He was interested.
They describe these experiences or these events like a person talks about something that has happened to them. And when you're talking with a psychotic who's telling you something and it's a delusion and you feel that it really didn't happen, I can tell. I mean, I know this is something that a person wants me to believe, or they're frightened, or they're distorting reality in some way. There's nothing like that here. These are people of sound mind, by and large, telling me something that's they know that I might think they're crazy, and so they're a little concerned about telling me, and they're very full of questioning themselves and doubt, and I mean the way, and then they describe something very real and intense, a light or something happened to their body, or it's the whole quality of the way they talk about it is the way a person talks about experience that happened to them.
John discovered that from Africa to Brazil, Australia to Turkey, all of the abductees described exactly the same beings. They were first depicted in 1977 in the film Close Encounters of the Third Kind. For the script, Spielberg took his inspiration from accounts by UFO experts and descriptions provided by abductees. Now, these beings appeared on the big screen as a result of people claiming to have witnessed them, and not the other way around. Certain traditional cultures have reported their existence for centuries. For example, Indians of the Amazonian rainforest dubbed these beings Ikuya, while they were referred to as the Mantidani by the South African Zulus. I discovered this aspect of John's work while I was staying with him. And it was here that I met Karen, one of his former patients. And when I met John, Karen had just moved into the top floor of this beautiful house. Karen spoke of abductions that had been reoccurring since she was a little girl. Another experiencer, Will, had been working for the last 5 years at John's research institute. Will and Karen both have vivid and conscious memories of their experiences, They both managed to overcome the initial trauma of these encounters better than most and live normally, while trying to come to terms with what really happened to them. It involves dealing with events which are not experienced in everyday life, missing time, intense physical sensations, etc.
Some of these experiences, I hate discussing memory because when you're having an experience, it doesn't feel like you've lost a part of your memory. It's more like time has been distorted.
Right.
You know, you walk into a hallway, something happens, and then it's 5 hours later.
Right.
It doesn't feel like you've lost a part of your memory. You were conscious and aware the entire time,
right.
But it seems like a section of your life got skipped.
Yeah, like edited out or
something. Yeah, got edited out of the film.
Yeah, like it's just like the film was just spliced together, so you're completely conscious and completely conscious, but the two frames don't make sense next to each other because there's this whole piece in the middle that's missing. So to give you a sense of what it would feel like, right now we're having tea together, yeah? So you have a sense of what this feels like to you, yes? Now imagine the very next second from when I stop speaking, all of a sudden you find yourself out in the street by the car. In the very next second, no skipping of time. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes.
So tea now, next second, outside car. And you're conscious here and you're conscious at the car. Wouldn't you wonder what happened? Like how you would be at the car and you would think, how the hell did I just get out here? I was just in that second before drinking tea. You don't remember walking away from the teacup. You don't remember walking to the door, saying goodbye to us. You have no idea what happened between the teacup and the car. But you were conscious at both places.
You say what?
It's peas and carrots. I took a couple of years.
When I woke up as an adult in the room filled with the blue light, for a moment, I thought to myself, is this a gas leak? Is this a gas explosion? Is there a fire? Followed immediately by the fear of, they're coming. And I tried to shove myself underneath the bed, tried to hide, tried to squirrel myself away because there was nowhere in this small room to hide. And then sure enough, door opens up and these two beings scurry in and one touches my leg, you know, very physical, touches my leg. And I knew that that light meant that those things were about to show up.
So the first part of it starts out as they meet us, as they meet the experiencer in this density, and it's that dense. But then there is the experience of being taken or leaving this dimension. And in the leaving of this dimension, things don't feel so dense, and they don't feel so dense. It feels like the vibration shifts, that everything speeds up. It feels like the body becomes light. And for me specifically, it felt like my cells were being pulled apart, and that the speed of everything moved up, like, you know, things were moving much quicker. If this was just something that was just happening, like it felt like in my mind, that just felt like dreams, I would have never told anybody about it. I would have kept that to myself. I'm aware that these stories are insane to the listener. I'm aware that they sound crazy to everybody else. Why would I want to go put myself out there and say, I have all these dreams that I think are real? That's retarded. That's stupid. I wouldn't do that. The only reason that I believe them, that they are what they are, is because my body was very physically involved in all of them, and because these experiences, these beings, physically interrupted my world.
What we've learned from many experiencers, including myself, who have described this experience in detail, I believe that what we're describing is two different realities meeting, mixing temporarily, and then separating, leaving very little evidence. So I believe that these meetings of two worlds, it seems to only be for a few minutes at a time. I don't know that an alien could appear in our world and stay here. What we've seen, or what I've seen, is them in our environment only briefly, 10 minutes, 5 minutes, 20 minutes. Then they remove us, me, anyone, from their environment, take them into their alien environment for most of the time, and then bring them back.
For centuries, people believed the Earth was flat. In the history of science, the most absolute certainties have been swept away by revolutionary discoveries. Could it be then that we're at the dawn of a new development?
Thank you.
I left Boston, heading for the Canadian border, where I had arranged to meet two New Yorkers, Michael and Trish. Michael's a writer, Trish a former company director. In September 1997, Michael and Trish, who had recently met, were preparing to spend their first weekend together. It was then that it happened, on this very spot.
Hi,